Sarah Thomas, a personal trainer, a fitness instructor, as well as a nutritionist. Today, I am here to give you a slider core workout. So although it's called a slider core workout, if you don't have sliders, no worries, you can still do this workout. If you are on a hard surface like I am today, you can simply use a towel or two to use as your sliders. If you're on carpet, grab some paper plates or even a top of a magazine. The magazine cover will allow your feet to slide and complete every single move that we have today. Okay, are you ready? Let's do it. Okay, so move number one today is going to be a mountain climber cross. So set yourself up into a plank first, stacking your shoulders right over top of your wrist. Make sure you pull that belly button tight to your spine, press back through your heels and keep your legs straight to start. Once you're set up correctly, we start our mountain climbers. These do not have to be fast. You're taking opposite knee to opposite elbow. Mountain climb, cross, opposite knee, opposite elbow. Now, if you feel like you want a little bit more speed, you can always pick it up. Crossing side to side across your body. Now for today's workout, there's no wrong or right as far as how many you do or how long you do the moves. You simply want to go until you fatigue. Do you feel like you can't do any more? So once you get to that point where you feel like you've got done plenty, your muscles are fatiguing, they're burning, then you can stop. That's our first move. We're moving on to the next move, which is a plank pike up. So you'd be back down here in that plank position. Legs nice and long, again, race through that core. From here, we're gonna lift straight up, booty to sky. Legs stay straight. Pike up, booty to sky, legs are straight, and back down. Now, if you can only come here, totally fine. Do what you can, and as you get stronger, you can take those legs a little bit closer. Make sure as you slide up, you use that core, you pull it to your spine every single time. Big breaths, and maybe just a few more, and then you can take a break. Okay, next up, we're doing a beast circle to plank. So if you haven't done a beast before, let me preview that before we get started. Come back here into all fours. So stack shoulders over top of wrist, stack hips over top of knees, and all fours. Your beast position, taking your toes, tucking them under, lifting your knees off the ground, about 2 inches. This is a beast. Come on out here with me in a beast. We're gonna hold nice and tight. It is harder than it looks. So from your beast, you're gonna take your feet, circle out, around to plank. Pull back into beast. Circle out, around to plank. Pull back to beast. Out, around to plank. So what you want to try to avoid is pulling your booty up high. Keep that position nice and tight, super strong. Oh yeah, we will not take many of these, will it? Pull back in. And last one. And if you didn't feel it, keep on going. Okay, last move in today's core slider workout. Taking these sliders on your feet here. Come all the way down your mat. This is called a super crunch. We're gonna pull up, reach the sky, pull those legs into you. And as you do this, put pressure into your heels and use your hamstrings to pull you up to the very top. Reach your arms to the sky, wrap it out in front of you, that's easier. So today we're gonna reach all the way up as high as you can go. Squeeze and lift, and that core should be trembling by now. Again, you go until you feel that your muscles have fatigued, and then you stop.
And there you have it. 4 moves for a core slider workout that is sure to burn from front to back all the way around that core for a tighter midsection this year. Guys, if you like this workout, don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe to the channel. I will see you soon.